ahora vamos a traer nuestras peticiones de oración frente a los demás niños. At this time, we will bring our prayers, petitions, and requests before God and one another. We want to start off by lifting up those who are ill with the flu or flu-like symptoms. We have so many. I've already got tests from entire families that are not here this morning because of multiple illnesses. So please keep those in your prayers. Of course, we had Friday. Bedford County schools were closed just for illness. Good thing we didn't use those snow days. So anyway, so please lift up those who have the flu or cold. There are so many. What other prayer requests would you like to lift up? I'll start over here. Other prayer requests would you like to lift up? Por Kathy, que se cayó por atrás o por el techo y para el piso en el garaje y está dando recuperado. Oraciones por Carrie Lindbergh, que está en el hospital con problemas de corazón y en San Pedro, no están seguros. Yes, your turn. Bonnie's friend who is having some medical tests. Oraciones por Keisha, una amiga de Bonnie, que tiene examinaciones médicas. Prayers for Megan and I as we move to Shelbyville Thursday. Oraciones por Megan y yo. Vamos a mudarnos para Shelbyville jueves.
Okay, so prayers for Elaine's niece in Oklahoma City, who
found out she has double breast cancer at age 36. Oraciones por la sobrina de Elaine, que está en Oklahoma, que tiene cáncer en ambos pechos a la edad de 46. But also, praise be God for your nephew and his wife, who just found out they're pregnant. So prayers for that pregnancy. Gracias a Dios, porque su sobrino y su esposa supieron que ella está embarazada, pero en las primeras semanas, oraciones por ella.
Prayers for Jim, who's having a 3-hour test, medical test tomorrow, that if he comes out well, things I can do to make her better.
All right, prayers for Shannon Falk and her medical test this week, that she might be able to improve. Oraciones por Shannon y su exámenes de salud esta semana. Prayers for John. His surgery was good, but his recovery is doing well, but his two fingers are still numb. Oraciones por John, que su cirugía fue buena, pero todavía le falta sentido en dos dedos, así que puede mejorar. Okay, so thanks for the prayers for Will Shaw. He is doing well, and he should be back home by the end of the month. Gracias por las oraciones por Will Shaw. Él debería poder regresar por el fin del mes. Prayers for prayers for Joanne and Randy, friends of Carol, who live in Morrison, kind of middle of nowhere. But Randy was told his cancer was gone a few weeks later, has come back and has been given 6 months to live. And so prayers for them. Oraciones por amigos de mi madrastra. Randy y Joanne. Randy pensaba que su cáncer había terminado bien, pero después de un mes supieron que tiene 6 meses para vivir. So. Unspoken prayer from Dicho. Oh, Jen, you were just... Prayers for Mary, a friend of Roger and Mary Cooley's, who has a serious liver disease and needs to go on transplant list. Oraciones for Mary, que es una amiga de Roger y Mary Cooley's, que tiene enfermedad del hígado muy seria y necesita trasplante.
Sabemos el problema, pero yo sabía.
pede, é possível que necessite cirurgia de oração? Oh, another. Continue to lift up Kathy Martin. She's doing well, but she had an eye operation. Continuamos a orar por Kathy Martin. Tuvo cirugía de ojo. Está bien, pero necesita continuar en el día. Well, let's take these prayers, those that are our hearts and minds, those que no hemos dicho, and lift them up to the Lord. Let us pray. Father, we thank you for being with us, always being God with us, never abandoning us, Lord, that you're with us in our suffering and our problems, Lord. Even though these events can be so difficult, Lord, we are truly blessed by your presence. We know that we are never alone, Lord. Sometimes we forget. We allow fear and anxiety to overcome us. Lord, we pray that you would instill in us a greater faith, that you would instill in us a greater certainty to know that you are with us, so that we may be able to witness that to others. Lord, we pray that those who are around these folks, that they would come to know you and to know your love. Lord, we don't ask for it selfishly because we need to grow our church. Lord, we ask it out of love, because we want them to have the peace that we have had, that we have experienced, that true peace of knowing that through your presence there is an eternal relationship that is irrevocable. Lord, we pray that if it be your will at all, that you would bring healing to these individuals, that you would bring comfort to those who mourn, and that you would provide an answer to those who are questioning. Lord, we pray all these things in the name of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. All right, this time a few ushers would come forward to collect today's offering. Si los quieres, pudieras venir para el ofrecimiento. And don't forget, the envelope is for Human Relations Sunday.
Oh, alumbra a todos los que están en casa. Así alumbra vuestra luz delante de los hombres para que vean vuestras buenas obras y glorifiquen a vuestro Padre que está en los cielos. You are the light, you are the salt of the earth, but if the salt loses its saltiness, how can it be made salty? It is no longer good for anything except to be thrown out and trampled underfoot. You are the light of the world, a town built on a hill cannot be hidden. Neither do people light a lamp and put it under a bowl. Instead, they put it on a stand, and it gives light to everyone in the house. In the same way, let your light shine before others, that they may see your good deeds and glorify your Father in heaven. This is the word of God, the Lord God, who will say,
thanks be to God.
Yes, it is important that we be a light and salt for the world, that our witness would be showing. Sometimes we think that our witness is very bright and good, and our intentions are great, but sometimes, even in those good intentions, we mislead or misguide. So, I actually typed the bulletin wrong. It should be verse 3, not 13 to 16. That's okay, it works, because it's the Beatitudes. Blessed are the poor in spirit, for they shall be shown. I can't quote that directly because I'm studying too many versions. They shall be. It'll be good. Well, that's what I want to start talking about. So, it's like, which one do I choose in my head? But the salt and the light, that's where we're heading with it. So I'm so glad that she read that because it very much goes in with what we're talking about. So if you want to go to your Bible, you see, blessed are those who are poor in spirit, for they shall inherit the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are the meek, for you know, that kind of thing. So what I want to talk about, because I did the salt sermon for the youth, the very first sermon I preached in here, before I was ever here on Sunday. So I did something different today, because we've already done it. But, still very important, have you ever used Facebook or Twitter or Instagram? Have you ever used social media? Please raise your hand so I can see who has never used social media. Please raise your hand. If you do, so that I don't make it. Yes, I use social media. Yes, yes, yes. I'm looking for those who don't raise their hand. Okay, good. All right. So most of us have used social media. Social media is where you get to post pictures of your favorite foods and talk about how good they are. If you've never used it, that's what it is. And there's something that we do called hashtag. Now, a hashtag is a number sign. Okay, you would think of it as a numeral. But a hashtag is actually the way that Twitter started, but everyone uses it now. All the different social media. That you can kind of like, it's almost like you register like for an index. Okay? So, for example, if you put a post and you put hashtag church, then if anyone were to look up the hashtag church, they might find your post. Now, your hashtag can be very specific or very general. So you could hashtag, I don't like chocolate ice cream or something. And everyone in the world, whoever hashtagged that, you could search by hashtag. It's kind of neat, right? Well, there's one hashtag very popular, uniquely in the American Christian community. And that is hashtag blessed. Have you seen hashtag blessed? Maybe you have done hashtag blessed. Have you seen it? Never. Never seen hashtag blessed. No? Megan, yes. Okay. I know you have. It's a what?
It's in a song.
It's even in a recent song. Have you all seen hashtag blessed, right? Okay, maybe this is a youth sermon again. Anyway, there are three situations in which people will put hashtag blessed. One is after they have had a very satisfying day with their family or loved one. Two is when they have had a very satisfying, delicious meal, always accompanied with a photo. Or three, after they have been to some sort of religious Christian function. You will almost never see hashtag blessed outside of that. Every now and then, like an answered prayer or something like that. Is this right? Is this about right? You, am I correct or am I wrong? If I'm wrong, tell me. Hunter, DJ, do you see hashtag blessed? That's the three times that you see it, isn't it? If I'm gonna plug it in, I may miss something. I'm good. All right, good. Those are the only times we ever use the word hashtag. All right, Zach, you tell me. Is that when you see hashtag blessed? Yes, thank you, Sandy. That's what we see. All right. My thing is, maybe we should say hashtag blessed a little differently if we're going to do it based on Scripture. Because Scripture says things like, blessed are those who are poor in spirit. The Scripture says, blessed are those who are persecuted. The Beatitudes, Matthew 5, 3 to 12, the beginning of the Sermon on the Mount. Some translations say happy, some say blessed, some say fortunate, some say favored. That Greek word means a combination of all those things. Blessedly happy, fortunate, and favored. Could all be that word. There's not an exact equivalent in English. It is a positive thing, though. It's not a negative thing. Scripture says that those who are poor in spirit should consider themselves hashtag blessed. You know, that's when you're humble and others are trying to make themselves big and puff themselves up and they're being the squeaky wheel and others are winning. They are hashtag winning and you are not. You are not getting the raise. You are not getting promoted because you are being humble. You are not favored by the eyes of others because you are simply working for the kingdom. This is the kind of scenario which you should put on your Facebook wall, hashtag blessed. Scripture says those who are mourning should consider themselves hashtag blessed. You know, when a close loved one dies in a car accident, or has been diagnosed with terminal cancer, or you have recently divorced or broken up with a long-term affair, or maybe when you can't provide for your family and you go to bed and your chest hurts because you don't know what to do. This is what Scripture says you should update your Instagram with hashtag blessed. Scripture also says those who are meek should consider themselves hashtag blessed. Think about for men especially. For men being meek in this world is awful, right? And this world tells us that we need to be tough and rugged, that we should be able to bring ourselves, other friends under the table and yet still be able to function and should drive home. Our society says that as young men in college, if we are not sleeping around with as many women as possible, that we are gay. Our society thinks men have to behave very, very much outside of the ideals of the Christian life, like hot shots. And if we don't, we are wrong. And when people think that we're weak and that we're unmanly, we should update our social media with hashtag blessed, because we are meek. Scripture says that those who hunger and thirst for righteousness should consider themselves hashtag blessed. You know, when people around you think, oh, you Christians, you're always fasting, and you're always trying to help people. You're too religious. You're crazy getting up in church and singing. Putting your arms in the air, you've lost your mind, right? You're just too churchy. You're too religious. I can't take you seriously, right? When your friends think you're stupid because you're Christian. In intellectual circles, happens all the time, by the way. If you're in any of those groups of like a bunch of professors or teachers, they think you're silly because you're Christian. When those people reject you, you should consider yourself hashtag blessed. Or how about when the Scripture says that those who are merciful should consider themselves hashtag blessed. That's when you love your enemies despite popular opinion, forgiving those who harm you or disagree with you. Yes, even politically. Yes, even on Facebook. When you show love and grace, even though people attack you, you should consider yourself hashtag blessed. Scripture says that those who persecute you, that they are causing you to be blessed. Those who wish to seek violence against you, those who wish to destroy destroy you in your career, those who wish to harm you socially, those who wish to bring about all kinds of evil, that you being persecuted because of your faith, you are hashtag blessed. In the early church, people were crucified, not just Jesus, but others were crucified because of their faith. In China today, for example, it is illegal to evangelize. Those who are persecuted for being Christian anywhere around the world are hashtag blessed. But it happens here too. It happens in smaller ways sometimes. And again, a summary of what we've talked about. When people eschew you, push you away because of your faith, you're not acting normal. That's a minor form of persecution. You could say, yeah, my friends ditched me and don't want to talk to me anymore. Hashtag blessed. Okay? That's the way we should be using that. And isn't it interesting that the situations under which Scripture says we are blessed, and these are the situations Scripture says we're blessed, and these are the situations when we say we're blessed online, there's no convergence. The Venn diagram never crosses. Of course, when we get good news, we are blessed. That is true. When we are healed, we are blessed. When we have good food, we are blessed. When good things happen, we are blessed. But guess what? You're not blessed because of what happens to you. You're blessed because God is with you. Which means you can't not be hashtag blessed. Because God desires a relationship with you. And if you're willing to accept that even a little bit, you are hashtag blessed. Your blessing is eternal, not in this very moment. So you may have had a really hard day, and that's painful, and it's real, and you are suffering, and you are crying, and you are hurting. That's true. It is painful. It is awful. It is not good. It is very sad. But you are blessed because of who blesses you, not because of what you experience in this world. But when all we post about is being blessed, when we have good food and fortune, what do other people think Christianity means? And the only time we're willing to say that we're blessed is when good things happen to us. Then when other people who are new to Christianity or interested in the gospel, when bad things happen to them, what are they going to think about God? They're going to think that you're only blessed at certain times and that God punishes you because you're wrong or evil or he fell out of love with you. And that's not the gospel. The gospel says that the greatest moment of love in history was during a crucifixion. Hashtag blessed. Let us give thanks to God. Whether the times are difficult or times are fantastic. For Megan and I, they are fantastic right now. Have never been better. But it won't be like that forever. There will be very difficult times ahead. We don't know what they are, but it's hashtag blessed. And some of you are going through very painful times, and I know that. But God is with you. He's never abandoned you. It is an eternal bless. You may not feel blessed today, but you are blessed for eternity. God always invites you into his personal relationship, into his self. Christ our Lord invites us to come and taste and see that, in fact, this is good. This relationship nourishes forever and is ready for anyone, who even thinks they might be interested. You don't even have to be all in. Just come and taste and see that the Lord is good. Christ our Lord invites all to this table who earnestly repent of their sins and wish to be at peace with one another. Now, this is not a Methodist table. This is not Bellbuckle Church's table. It's not Pastor Eric and Laura's table. This is the Lord's table open to all who wish to come to it. Cristo nuestro Señor invita a su mesa a quienes le aman, a quienes verdadera y sinceramente se arrepienten de sus pecados y procuran vivir en paz con el prójimo. No es una mesa naturista, tampoco es la mesa de Bel bajo iglesia, sino es del Señor. Therefore, let us confess our sins before God and one another in a prayer of silent repentance. Por lo tanto, confesemos nuestro pecado en una oración en silencio. Oremos. Let us pray. Sacrifice. Father, we thank you for the pardon of our sins. We praise you for it. Gracias por el perdón del pecado, Señor, y lo que has hecho para perdonarnos. Hear the good news. Escuchan las buenas nuevas. Dios muestra su amor para con nosotros en que siendo aún pecadores, Cristo murió por nosotros. Christ shows his love for us, that even though we were yet sinners, he has accepted us and given us his love. En el nombre de Jesucristo, todos somos perdonados. In the name of Jesus Christ, we are all forgiven. Glory to God. Amen.
Open your hearts. En Jesús de God, eleven sus corazones y den gracias a Dios. It is right and joyful thing, always and everywhere, to give thanks to you, Father Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth. You formed us in your image and breathed into us the breath of life. When we turn away and of our way, of love faith, your love remains steadfast. Tú nos libraste del cautiverio, hiciste un pacto para ser nuestro Dios soberano y nos hablaste por medio de los profetas. Y así con todo tu pueblo, con toda la compañía del cielo, alabamos tu nombre y nos unimos al himno eterno. Santo, santo, santo es el Señor, Dios Todopoderoso. Llenos están los cielos y la tierra de tu gloria. Hosana en las alturas. Bendito sea aquel que viene en el nombre del Señor. Hosana en las alturas.
Holy are you, Lord, and blessed is your Son, Jesus Christ. Your Spirit anointed him to preach good news to the poor, to proclaim release to the captives and recovery of sight to the blind. You set at liberty those who were oppressed, and you came to announce the time had come when you would save your people. Jesus healed the sick, fed the hungry, and he ate with sinners. It's true. Inmediato el bautismo de su sufrimiento, muerte y resurrección, diste nacimiento a tu iglesia, y nos libraste de la esclavitud del pecado y de la muerte, e hiciste con nosotros un nuevo pacto mediante el agua y el Espíritu. Y cuando el Señor Jesús ascendió a los cielos, prometió estar siempre con nosotros en el poder de su palabra y del Espíritu Santo.
On the night in which Jesus gave himself up for us, he took bread, gave thanks to you, broke the bread, gave it to his disciples, and said, "Take, eat. This is my body, which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me."
Asimismo, tomó la copa, después de haber cenado, y dijo, "Esta copa es el nuevo pacto en mi sangre. Hacer esto todas las veces que la bebieres en memoria de mí."
And so, in remembrance of this, your mighty acts in Jesus Christ, we offer ourselves in praise and thanksgiving as a holy and living sacrifice. As we proclaim the mystery of God, the mystery of faith, Cristo ha muerto, Cristo ha resucitado, Cristo vendrá otra vez.
Let us pray. Oremos. Señor, derrama tu Espíritu Santo sobre los que estamos aquí reunidos y sobre estos dones de pan y copa. Haz que sean para nosotros el cuerpo y la sangre de Cristo, para que seamos el cuerpo de Cristo para el mundo, redimidos por su sangre. Sunday. By your Spirit, make us one with Christ, one with each other, and one in ministry to all the world, until Christ comes in final victory, and together we feast at his heavenly banquet. Through your Son, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit in your holy church, all honor and glory is yours, Almighty Father, now and forever. Amen. And now with the confidence of children, let us pray as our Lord taught us in whichever language we choose. Y ahora, con la confianza de ser hijos e hijas de Dios, oremos al Padre nuestro en el idioma que escojamos. Our Father, que estás en los cielos,
those assisting our communion, please come forward.
Let us pray. Eternal God, we give you thanks for this holy mystery in which you, God, have given yourself to us to be with us forever. Concédenos que podamos vivir en el mundo con el poder de tu Espíritu en el nombre de Jesucristo nuestro Señor. #blessed. Amen.
Amen. Let's stand together with us.
Directly in my office, so if you need to sing, I'm there.